We moved in this building in July of 1964. Before that, the library was in the basement of the mansion. W.B. West was a book collector. The books were scattered all over the mansion. Same thing at his house. Everywhere you opened a door, there were more books. In the early 50s, they started the graduate program at Harding and Searcy. When they began the school in Searcy, they provided some money and some funds to buy some material just for that program.
Well, when we started, we didn't have very much that you could call a library.
When the school moved over here in 1958, those were brought over here. I'm not sure the exact number, but there were not a whole lot of books in that collection. And Dr. Lewis was even the one that opened the boxes when they came over here and helped put them on shelves in what was in the bookstore. One of the most significant things he did was in 1970s, he set up an endowment fund for the library in honor of his parents.
Well, I set up an endowment for the library so that it continued to grow. And so we are in the process of building the best theological library between Nashville and Dallas on the one hand, and between St. Louis and New Orleans on the other hand. Today, we have a collection that is not to be ashamed of.
We have been able to spend $499,000 beyond what we would have had in our budget because of the endowment fund that Dr. Lewis set up. So he's been a very important part of this library.
I went to Harding Academy, and when I got ready to go to college, of course, I went to Harding College. And Annie Mae Austin was my freshman English teacher.
Well, in the first place, she loved books. She just lived for the library during the time she was librarian.
She cared about her students. She cared about what we were doing. She was interested in us.
Collection development has been my chief interest here. I picked up a lot of good hints from Annie Mae on how to do that. A lot of things made her unique and a great librarian.
One thing I remember is when she became the librarian. See, she had taught English and she had taught in Harding College, but at the same time she was going to school and becoming a librarian. And so when she gave up her teaching and became a librarian, many of us were upset because she had been a master teacher and she had been such an encourager. That was one thing about Annie Mae. She was an encourager.
She worked incredibly hard. When she was librarian at Harding and Searcy, and that's where she came from to come over here in 1962. And she brought that same incredible work ethic over here. She worked many, many long hours to get this library where it is.
Oh yeah, Don and I call each other brother and sister. She was his mentor and helped him become the librarian.
Don Meredith can find anything, and he knows what page it's on and what bookshelf it's on. He can walk you straight to it.
He's also just always willing to sit down and help students and talk to them and just snippets of wisdom and knowledge here and there.
I'd worked with Annie Mae, was then Annie Mae Austin when she was librarian at Harding for 3 years. When I came over here in the fall of 1963 to be a student and work toward the MTH, which we now call the MDiv, she asked me if I wanted to work in the library. And obviously I said yes. And so the 4 years I worked toward my degree, I worked here in the library.
The librarian, Don Meredith, is fantastic and unique in his abilities to know the collection. He just, you know, off the top of his head, seemingly is able to give me and students guidance to books and other items in the collection.
One of the most important thing about this great library is the librarians themselves. They are very friendly and very helpful, and I feel here at home.
So I left here, I think, in August of 1964. And in October, she called me and said, "Say, would you be interested in coming back here and being our second professional librarian?" And so obviously I said, wow, yes, I'd certainly be glad to come back. I never had to search for a job. I didn't have to do interviews because this has been the only job that I've ever had, is working in this library. As we moved on into the later years, in the last 10 or 15 and 20 years, there's been more of a focus here on biblical studies, particularly New Testament world. Of course, some people that come to this library are surprised that it's not a glorified church library. And they're really kind of amazed that the depth and breadth of materials we have.
For the past 20 years, I'm a regular here at Harding. I come every morning to work in the library. The library is wonderful.
I've been coming here to the library for about 7 years, and it's been a great place for me to study, to pray, to have a quiet space.
The library was just really essential to what I do here in terms of research and my classes.
There's no way to do serious theological reflection and study without having an amazing library. I would tell anybody that the library at Harding School of Theology is second to none, and I would not have been able to complete my education had it not have been for the amazing library at Harding.
I always tell students they need to go and look at what the ancient authors said, not just what somebody tells us they say. And our collection here is essential for that. If we didn't have this collection, students really would not be able to do responsible graduate study.
Every book that I need or article I can find here in the library.
And the library is more than just a resource for just information, but it's also a place to where the student body gathers to study together, share and discuss different ideas.
Well, it is always good to be able to sit in the library and see people walk by, and people will come and join you and kind of bounce ideas off of them.
And I think part of the thing that makes this library so special is just the people here that are willing to take the time to help you.
Upstairs is a place that you can meet other students and chat. Downstairs is the quiet space where you get a lot of writing done. The different areas of the library are set up really conducive for study. It's helpful.
The way that the library has definitely challenged me to think a little bit more open-mindedly is there's more than one side to a conversation. And being in the library, I get to overhear both sides.
The staff in the library are great. Not only are they extremely helpful, the library is a fun place to be.
Although I teach at the U of M, still it's really my home here at this great library.
A place where I can reflect. Harding really has provided that place for me, and so I'm very thankful for that.
Part of having a good collection to do research and Bible backgrounds are materials that come from both archaeology and also information related to the authors of the ancient world. And the collection here has been growing significantly, really since its beginnings, but also since I've been here.
The library here is organized, you have all the material.
And one of the things I appreciated so much about this library is how many resources there are from different people from all over the spectrum.
I'm so thankful for Harding School of Theology's hospitality that they've shown me and other local pastors.
I think the library just serves as a lifeline for ministers, and it can definitely just enrich their preaching with just the amount of resources here, the depth and breadth that's here. It can just, it's just a mine that preachers can come into and take out little nuggets to bring back to their congregations.
The library just opened up infinite possibilities for me, because no matter what I was researching or looking at, I could go in there and find all kinds of resources that were at my disposal to search for truth and to love truth.
Not everyone's able to come and just look through all of these, but if you digitize it, everyone's able to kind of scroll through and see things that they find interesting and learn from different people that have written things 200 years ago that, you know, you never knew of before.
The administration at Harding University has really supported this library well.
No, hey, this is the greatest library, I can tell you for sure. I'm serious about it.
Perfect, as your Father in heaven is perfect. That's the impossible dream of Christianity.
Jesus said, all you need to do, you don't need to be so good yourself, but be good as you can and lift me up.
Great clouds all over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it all? Tumbling down in the city.